All right, here we go.
Put you out with the helicopter. They're playing Man Overboard. Watch the KBC and run. Got my son Tim on cam. Hot at the camera, Tim. Just tell me he ain't listening, bro. Yeah, she fell down to bust her butt right though. She's still strong though. I'm gonna drag off my pajamas and zoom in on that. Look at mine. My pajamas.
Overboard, round two. Thank you.
attempts on camera, please.
Thank you.
Day two. Seven.
It gets real, nigga. 2008, nigga. 2008, nigga. Yeah, nigga. Come on.
Now, Billy back there trying to hide. Billy trying to hide from the camera.
Baseball player.
What's up, baseball player, Rita?
Yo, when I get raped.
Yeah,
Amber,
sing that song,
Amber. Amber going long?
That's my jam.
Oh, yeah.
Several rooms in there, but one of the rooms that you're going to take you to will have all the plaster stripped off the walls where you can see the wall, the insulation in the wall, what they call horse eyes, is actually kind of camouflaged because they've got across that same wall a lot of wood strips running across that's called plaster lamp. That's what, when we used to have plaster walls, actually some houses we still have today that's got plaster walls. Most of our houses are got sheetrock on the wall, but they put strips of wood across the walls and then they put plaster on top of that material, something like a sheetrock, but it, you mix it up and you have to apply it to the wall. Well, they're going to take you to this room and you're going to be able to see that. But what I'm going to show you here today is how they actually made that pussy eyes and how they installed it in the walls. In the early 1700s, when the French people first settled the territory here, and thank you, I won't be able to talk. When they first settled in the territory, where the early 1700s, and began building homes to live in, they couldn't find building materials they was accustomed to using for making what they call pussy eyes, the insulation material in the walls, which was made with clay and straw. Here, there was no crops or any kind of plants that generated straw. But there were some Indian tribes living along the river at that time who built their homes, the walls of their homes, using the same process is this pussy eyes process, which was clay, but instead of using straw to bind that clay together, they used Spanish moss. Everyone knows what green Spanish moss looks like. You see it hanging on the oak trees and the cypress trees. How about this? You know what that is?
African moss right there. Huh? African moss right there.
That's cured Spanish moss.
Oh,
that's still Spanish?
You take a green Spanish moss and stack it up on the ground on a large pile and keep that pile wet and the pile turned over every other day. In about a month or a month and a half, the outer coating, this green coating on these plants will decay away. This plant is very weak. Underneath that green coating, you're going to find this very strong fiber, like that. And this is what they mix with their clay to bind it together. They also use this for a lot of other things, which I'll be talking about later in my demo. Now, to mix this clay with the Spanish moss, the Indians told them, simply dig you a large shallow hole in the ground. But before they'd done that, they had to collect the clay. Now, they could have dug it out of the ground, but most likely collected it from along the river here or along the bayou, because clay coming from those areas is much better for making the bushes. The clay is not too wet or too dry, has the right consistency for molding and shaping, which they had to do to install it in the walls. Now, as I said earlier, the Indians told them to dig a large shallow hole in the ground. Put the clay in it that they collect from along the river. On top of that clay, pile in a whole lot of this cured moss that they made up. And then saturate all of that with a lot of water. And then physically jump in that hole with their bare feet and just start walking on top of that clay and moss until they got the two to blend together. The moss mix well in with the clay. Like that. That's what's holding that clay together, that moss. Once they've got the moss and the clay blended together, they then pull chunks of that mixture out of the hole and formed it into a shape in preparation for installing in the walls of the house. They shaped it up like that, what they call a torche, which was a French term for loaf, because it appeared to them a similar shape as a French loaf of bread. This is typically how the walls were framed. Building was structured. Walls were structured. You will not be able to see this when you go look at the walls in the main house. They'll be all covered up with the bushes and the plaster lath, so you won't be able to see the framing the way it is. All the building framing materials were cypress. Cypress trees grow in the swamp. The wood resists rotting. Wood also resists termites, which we have a problem here with in this area with termites. These wood posts that support the walls could vary in thickness. The main house, this wood post, the cypress post that hold the walls up, are 6 inches by 8 inches, big heavy duty timber. Smaller homes like this overseer's home, the posts are around 5 inches thick. Wood bars were put between the posts from the floor to the ceiling to hold this bushes in place. You just cannot stack that in here. The bushes, it would simply collapse and fall out of the wall. Now they put the bushes in every interior wall of a house. All walls around every room and all the perimeter walls inside the house was filled with bushes. Now once they've established their wall, got their wall structure done, and they had bushes made up and ready to install, they would take the torche like this and place it over the bar in this manner and blend it in the wall. They had already got the wall started, and they were just playing it as an original piece. They had not sunned the wall. They would put the first piece up again. That will get hard like a rock. But it will also melt away pretty quickly if left exposed to heavy rain. The very first houses these people built, when they first began building anyways, they just left their wall exposed like I've got it right there. Rainy season come along.
The things that were actually used years ago, some of the things that are actually used in hospitals nowadays were very well, et cetera, et cetera. So if you're not interested, fine, but if you are interested, if we could sort of gather around, we'll talk about them for a few minutes, okay? But about half the things that I'm actually going to talk about actually was used on me when I grew up in central Mississippi. I'm the 12th kid in a family of 13 children. Father never earned $1,000 a year in his life. So whenever my mother either wanted to keep me from catching something, if she wanted to, you know, get me well, these are the type of things that she actually had to use. If you could just sort of get the people who led to either
be
come
quiet, y'all.
People who are not interested, if they could just move out and close the door. But as I was saying, you know, many, many years ago, I grew up on a farm up in central Mississippi, and these are the type of things that were actually used on me when I was growing up. And then years after I left Mississippi, I actually wound up after doing a stint in the Air Force out in California in the early 60s. And when I went to California in the early 60s, this public school system in California was totally free, including the University of California system. So if you had good grades and if you could actually buy your books, you could actually go to school, okay? So I actually lost my excuse for not going to college. So I took a job in the San Francisco post office and worked from midnights to 8:30 in the morning, worked my way through the pre-pharmacy program at City College of San Francisco, and then I entered the Doctor of Pharmacy program at University of California, and I actually earned a Doctor of Pharmacy degree, and I was hired as a professor in their College of Pharmacy a year before I actually graduated there, and then I taught there for a year, and I went on to University of Michigan and taught for 30 years, and then I retired after teaching in 30 years in their College of Pharmacy. And I say that to say that when we were...
It's your boy Mike, aka B-Kim, aka Big Mike, also known as Young Man, also known as Big Mike. What's happening with y'all? So all the pretty ladies, man, look, what's happening with y'all, cutie? But the boys that have little booze, you heard it, but no trip. Like, after about 3 weeks from now, y'all can mess with me. I don't want Chris to think, I don't know, his mama might watch. So, when I turn 18, look, all y'all 21, y'all holler. If I turn 21 in about 2 weeks, you'll holler.
We're a broadcasting guy from the Elgin Spirit.
Hold it down.
Oh, look at smoke going on. Byron over there. KC Byron. Byron can't be seen.
I'm gonna wrap up.
Mr. Marcus, get Mr. Marcus on camera, son. Oh, Mr. Marcus. There she go.
Mr. Marcus.
Epic Mike.
They already know how to
build a red and black ass. Get Bean over there fucking caking and shit. Let's go about Bean, man. Bean over there caking. All that Bean. Look, Bean caked out. Look at that boy cake.
Look
at that boy cake. He from Harvard. He ain't about shit. Look at him. He caked with her. He out here kegging. I'm about to shoot that bitch. He's wearing my sister. That's Uptown Latoya. Tony a fucking gangster. He hit the road. That's sitting big ass. But back to Justin over here. Justin is still a hoe.
This is how
I
ring on the hand.
He is still a hoe.
This is how I ring on the
hand. He married my sister. He's eating shit. That boy mad. At Byron, Dino, Capo, what I wrote. Oh, Gunsmoke
live. Oh, what's happening? You hear me? This Gunsmoke live in the building. You hear me?
Gunsmoke live in the building. That bow-legged red. Bow-legged red. That big shot day here, man, my dog. Oh! That doo-doo. This is nigga counterpart. Nigga, other half.
I'm that nigga. 7 KNT. 7 KNT.
Get it
back
on the lock. Lock it.
They had to turn it.
There you go. There you go. At E. Big E. A stupid ass. At E. One more time. You remember that T-shirt? No. That T-shirt?
Rap about money and a nigga might shine. Yeah. Rap about E and a nigga might find.
Well, he can rap for real, that's not him though.
That's
my nigga. Big Moose, aka G-Rail, aka Fooling with the Tool, 7 KNT, I don't know what I told you that. There's a gap right there, lock the gap. Lock that shit, no, just tripping. Tripping, it's a 7 KNT. That's that shit. There you go, bitch. Man, I done hit on it.
Rap for the ferry, you heard me? Well, I let y'all lead.
This buddy won't come over.
Wait, I missed it.
I got that bit.
I missed it. You got it?
Yeah. Whoa, look at that. I killed myself.
You got to do it right now. What's going to do?
That's Chris Brown.
Hey, the man who you say
they got what in her?
Thank you.
try to speak. Got a girl trying to skate over here. Everybody trying to learn. I just observed this at the kiddie pool.
Oh! Tacosville! Tacosville!
Black man. He's a professional skater. Show something, Jay. Show something for the camera. Do something spectacular for the camera.
I can't do it.
Ah, you suck. You suck.
We ain't gonna skate, man. Come on, dude, we're doing it. We're doing it, man.
Skating ring, man. FLY, we in the building. We don't know how to skate, though. but you know, he's gay.
Trail, trail.
What are you talking about, though? Hey, man, give me a camera out here.
You can't even go show the little kids how to do it, you know?
Will you skate that Taffy, bro? Can you skate?
Thank you.
for that shit, Bama. Look at the artist. He's just chilling, keeping it real, you know. Trail. He's tired of people looking at him and stuff. He's there chilling, you know. Look at the camera. Yeah, he's itchy, man. He's there chillaxing. Oh, look at him. Can Frank come over there? Oh my God, I'll call you.
Is that what I think it is?
Look, I call you, man. There's a cool car you don't know that.
Looking for something?
You call your dad bad for being over there. Hey, she naked. So that's how she looks.
Don't go.
Oh, man.
Two bears. Come on. Look. Look. I
bear.
Saw it.
Two bears. Oh.
Two bears.
Oh no, look at that bear leg. Child bear. The fluffy little bears. Oh, look at that bear leg.
Come on, bear, look over here. Take a picture.
Woo, Ashley!
Yeah,
like
so cute.
Dog.
I want one, y'all.
Hop your ass in there and get it.
I bet you they about $3,000.
What the name
be? And very destructive.
I don't care. I want it.
My favorite animal, man.
They're sniffing each other.
No, they're not there. Oh, yeah, they all there.
He licking the ass and shit.
So they going to grow?
Yeah, they going to.
It's Pauly. So, Pauly.
Turn your ass around.
Pauly the bird. Bird Pauly. All right, don't talk. You give him a cracker.
Jason, to Bob back, please.
There's only one black sheep in the whole world. Oh, Billy, what the hell these things are?
This ain't the discovery.
Look at that lamb.
He's fat.
All
of that. Oh, that bit of evil right there. Look at that bit growling at you.
Bitch. This bitch touched me one more time. I'm gonna get him in his mouth.
What? They're about to attack. Then it's too stupid. They got that new movie coming out. The lamb's killing people. Hmm.
Oh, my goodness.
It's not true. That bad. That bad. That bad. Pregnant or something.
Big with a skinny neck.
Nah. Oh, it's attacking. It's attacking.
One lamb's attack.
I've been trying to bite you, Jay. Put your hand right there, fool. Put your hand so we go bite you.
Bah.
Come on, you.
Yeah, come on, don't move. The monkey right here, you hear me? Beat his meat. Try to get him, he dead. You know. Care for monkeys, know you gotta respect these dead. I mean, I've been whacking that meat, look. Come see if you're in the meat, fool.
Alright, you
wanna see? Oh, that bear ugly.
You got a small monkey right
there. That bear ugly.
Look up here.
This is the Telmarium, the Golden Lion. Then he's going in to see. It's so cute.
feel like a cat. Where's his friend? His first friend. Look at his friends right there. He up there chilling. People again see there. What kind of monkey these are?
Like a howler monkey.
Like a what?
Like a howler monkey.
There's a black howler monkey. Oh. Hey, they're chilling. Oh, monkeys. They're trying to get their picture taken. Uh-oh. Whoa! Hey, hey, hey! Look at that action.
Yeah.
Hot monkey action.
Let's see, I'm gonna give him a show.
Catching his stomach.
He's swinging by the tail.
Might be a little hungry day.
I smell these Doritos.
Oh, the monkey in there. Oh, he's still chilling. Here's a little kind of monkey this is. See, I got a Family Guy shirt on, look like. He's a tooth about to kill himself. He's about to jump off. He's about to kill himself, ladies and gentlemen. Please, don't do it, monkey. He don't want to be seen behind his face. Oh, this monkey poor, man. No, huh?
Dumped
that thing. Smell his butt. Let me finish for him.
Dumped that thing.
That nigga nasty.
What y'all looking at me poo for? I can't poo in peace. Yeah.
What am I?
It's King Kong. He tried to hide his face from embarrassment. Look, it's Bama. Where's Bama, huh?
Wait, let it come down.
It's a true Bama girl, I forgot.
Look at that bug.
Look at Spider-Man, look, he got his cape on. I'm tripping, Superman.
He missed it. He even had the shirt on. He put the shirt on himself.
He did?
Yeah.
No, huh?
Yeah, he put the shirt on his own head.
That's been smart. Come back.
He took the shirt on. God damn.
Oh, cut his shirt.
You gotta put it back on.
You want to go hide. Oh, they got one of them here? something but be bad or something. This is the seals. Just family chilling today. The man over here chilling. Bloody thing you know, keeping the gangster.
Mommy!
The gangster's still right here. Oh, God is calling you.
I'm
not gonna lose throw, you know. Flex the muscles. Oh, man. Hard feeling like these days.
I wonder if the red thing is part in the inside of the head. That might be shagging
the head. Find here. Oh, they clipped it on it. Yeah, on top of the air.
That man had big, he ain't got a bike, he was Texas.
The Lion King.
Texas
the glass from the Lion King.
Gonna be by himself. So I like you with everybody else today.
I don't see anybody in the
go at the lazy bear exhibit. They're very, very lazy. Observe the laziness.
This is the bear society. Them niggas lazy, bruh. Look at this nigga, he can't even go up the stairs, lazy ass. Oh, try to go up the stairs and stop. Nigga really asleep. He got one bell over here, he ain't even moving. Shit, it ain't happening, Nisha no more.
I know that, you see that one
up there. I'm talking about
luck. They need to come from up there. They know that we fall down, that they don't have to come from up there.
How the fuck you get up there in
the ladder.
The one that's fall down, they gonna come down.
Throw a piece of meat in that thing. Gentlemen, the helicopter cougar.
You saw that boy showing his teeth when I walk him up?
Mm-hmm.
He bad too.
He's very tired.
Boy, I go back to sleep. You know that I already got boo-boo animals out
there. The hell is that Scooby?
You lost it now.
Helen Cox Cougar.
Yeah, y'all don't see me now. Can I get back to sleep?
That's neutral.
Pretty big issue. Oh yeah. Yep, sure is.
So they related to you wanna do like an old man thing?
Sorry. Gappy Barris.
So what? Oh. All these animals. Who can say? Oh, he dancing. Oh. He ewing. Uh oh. He getting loose. Oh! Why hitting that Chris Tucker?
Stop moving.
Oh, what is that? Oh, it's his hand. I'm tripping.
His feet look like a head. Look like a bamboo.
Look like two. This is X-rated zoo.
Come on, Jado.
X-rated zoo. Oh, is it a baby?
Look at his legs.
That looks later like a animal.
Like another animal.
Yeah. This is a party for real. Man, Elix got the long face. I mean, I'm like on his back. I thought they were trying to hump each other or something.
Me too. That's the
show. Oh. Get that bear. Sneak him. He don't want it. Look, he don't want it. Sneak that mug. You're talking all that yet.
Huh?
Uh-oh. Oh, they don't want to fight no more. Uh-oh. You're playing that sneaky route. Oh. Nigga, get with him. Oh.
Come on. Later?
Yeah, that's
okay. Well, took flight on him. Trying to run away. Oh, don't run. Uh-oh. Get that ball mine right. At Helen Cox High School class of the week, as you see. Big boy! Damn, this is stupid.
Damn, are we deep in the mud?
Get my camera from me, Jordan.
That's a good girl.
Who is this?
Okay, I took this one.
Which one? That one?
The other one. Let me up.
Ella Cox senior class.
Get another one.
Good girl.